Welcome to the show. And Kevin, if you're watching, please phone home. See, we've got a government being killed by two foreign affairs disasters. There's the boat people fiasco and the ban on our cattle exports to Indonesia. But has anyone seen the foreign minister? Where is Kevin Rudd? He's not in Malaysia trying to get its signature on a deal to swap 800 of our boat people for 4,000 of their refugees. That deal is still not signed, although Prime Minister Gillard announced it 5 weeks ago.
800 people seeking to come to Australia by boat, hoping to have their claims processed in Australia, hoping to end up resettled in Australia, will be taken to Malaysia instead.
If even this agreement falls over, this government really is toast. Rudd is also not in Papua New Guinea, where he could help to save another Gillard plan to send our boat people to Manus Island.
We've been exploring with PNG the possibility for an assessment centre to be based there.
It seemed PNG would agree, but now its Prime Minister is sick, its Foreign Minister sacked, and Manus Island is off their agenda. Port Moresby's governor says he'll even take legal action to stop Gillard.
I think that it's immoral of us to, you know, seem to be making money out of misery of some people who are trying to seek a brighter future in Australia.
Here's another place Kevin Rudd isn't: Indonesia. Our government says it's so disgusted by the way Indonesia kills our cattle that it can't have any more. That's a third of Indonesia's beef supplies banned. So why isn't Rudd there, trying to save our exports and keep sweet our neighbour? What do we pay him for if it's not to fix exactly these kinds of crises in our foreign affairs? Glad you asked. Thing is, he's been everywhere this past month except in Indonesia, Malaysia and Papua New Guinea, where Gillard actually needs him. He's instead been in Bangkok, Helsinki, Stockholm, Oslo and Guangzhou. Then he was off again to Budapest, Abu Dhabi, New York and London. Was he on urgent business in our national interest? Well, no. With the Finnish foreign minister, he talked about Syria and even how Finland won the world ice hockey title.
He did a so-called lacrosse goal, which you don't see very often. You flip the puck onto the stick like that, go around the net and hook it in. I'll send you a couple of YouTube video clips on it.
With the Norwegian foreign minister, he talked about the Middle East, his new obsession. In Abu Dhabi, he talked about Libya. In New York, he talked about AIDS. And he also took in some UN conferences, angling for that UN job. Meanwhile, the Gillard government is going down in flames as it torches our relationships with our neighbours. So where's Kevin? Why isn't he trying to save Julia Gillard? Stupid question. Senator John Faulkner was one MP to walk poor Kevin Rudd back to his office after he was dumped as Prime Minister. On Thursday, Faulkner called on Labor to stop listening just to opinion polls and the faction bosses who dumped Rudd, and consult instead their values and their members. As it happens, for the first time in Labor's 4 years in power, its backbenchers have revolted, forcing the government to ban exports of cattle to Indonesia. Crucial in that was MP Kelvin Thomson. Kelvin, what happened? What took this issue? How come it took this issue to finally get the backbench to say something?
Good morning, Andrew. I think that all of us who watched the Four Corners program were horrified at the revelations, to watch cattle trembling uncontrollably as they saw other cows in front of them being killed and cut up. And I think that caucus members, like ordinary Australians, were highly affected by that. And many of them, about 20, spoke about this issue very strongly in the meeting which we had the next day.
And that forced the government to do what it hadn't been contemplating, which was the ban. But I'm just wondering why it took this issue 4 years into the Labor government for the backbench finally to exert its will.
Well, there are all sorts of issues which come up, of course, and they get resolved by discussions between the ministers and the caucus members and other interested parties. But this was something where we'd seen the footage the night before. I guess it was very fresh in people's minds.
A shocking footage.
Indeed. People were shocked by it, and so it was raised that morning and people demanded action.
But it's interesting, isn't it, that it comes now that John Faulkner is saying this is the sort of thing, I presume, that he would like to see, where the Labor Party talks to people like you, or the government talks to people like you, rather than faction bosses or suppressing it. You must have felt it very ironic when Kevin Rudd said he agreed. After all, wasn't that for 3 years he wasn't listening to you guys?
Well, I think it's a bit late in the day for some people to become starry-eyed crusaders against excesses of the leadership. These are people who've been involved in the leadership for years now, and so to say that there are problems, well, these are problems which have arisen on their watch.
Yes. Well, do you see this as a sort of harbinger of issue of the way to come? Is the backbench, do you think, going to throw its weight around a little bit more often?
I hope that people are prepared to say what they think, Andrew. I think that it's a great opportunity and privilege to be a Federal Member of Parliament, and I don't think we should waste it. I think we should say what we think. We should seek to have an influence on public policy.
And what issues do you think will come up? You know, for example, you've protested about sending cattle to Indonesia. Do you think the backbench will protest about sending children to Malaysia, for example?
It's a bit difficult to predict what issues will be the ones which are most hotly debated and which will not. Of course, many of these issues have had a long history. The question of treatment of refugees and asylum seekers has had a long history, for example. But the issue about the live export of cattle to Indonesia came essentially out of a clear blue sky. Although some people have been aware of these things, I think, frankly, most of us had not. So it's a bit difficult to predict what issues will be important in future, but I hope that people talk about the things that are important to them and talk about their values and their policies and their convictions.
Stand up a bit more often.
I think that would it serves the Labor Party better, and it serves the Australian national interest better if we do say what we think rather than being simply top down and top driven.
That's right. With Julia Gillard, though, is this revolt a sign of weak leadership on her part or a more healthy democracy within the Labor Party?
I think it's certainly the latter. It's a sign of healthy democracy, and as I say, it wasn't a question of her leadership. It was a question of an immediate response to our becoming aware of the situation of the cattle in Indonesia.
Good on you. Kelvin Thomson, thanks for joining us.
Good to talk with you.